Welcome to our new IBBLE Bits show, where we'll keep you in the loop with six of the most trendy and newsworthy stories of the day. Today we're talking about Kanye West, American Airlines, women's soccer, and more. Let's get going. Matt Marshall, founder and former leader of a far-right group, was pranked at his March for Our Rights rally. The prank was led by the comedian behind the Borat character, Sacha Baron Cohen, where he managed to pull off a racist sing-along on stage and got the audience to happily sing along.
We gotta do, inject him with the Wuhan flu.
Marshall attempted to stop the prank by cutting off the mic, but was stopped by the guards, even though it was his own event. Photos and videos of the prank went viral over the weekend on Twitter. Those of us who wear prescription glasses, including me, have stumbled upon the worldwide problem of fogged up lenses while wearing a face mask. How do we solve this problem? First, be sure to check and see if your masks fit loosely around your nose, and if it's loose, then the air coming out of your nose is fogging up your glasses. In order to prevent this problem, invest in a mask that is adjustable to fit your nose. Use twist ties, wear your glasses over the mask material, try placing a folded tissue under the mask, and lastly, you could try anti-fog spray or wipes. I personally think I'm just gonna buy the $30 anti-eyeglass fog mask from Under Armour. Kanye West just signed a 10-year partnership with The Gap to create a Yeezy Gap clothing line. This is a huge bet for Gap since the brand has been struggling for the past 5 years to stay relevant, which has resulted in dwindling stock prices. The big announcement caused shares to surge nearly 40%. That's the Yeezy effect for ya. The partnership sounds like it was destined to be, since Kanye has always dreamt of partnering with the retailer after working for Gap in Chicago when he was a teenager. With Kanye, Yeezy's shoe line bringing in a whopping $1.3 billion in annual sales, Gap and its investors are all hoping to see the same results for Yeezy Gap. The Women's World Cup is back in action, y'all. The US Women's Soccer League is the first professional sport to resume play since March when the pandemic hit. The new 2020 schedule consists of 8 teams coming together to play 4 games. Then the teams will enter a single elimination tournament with a champion crowned sometime mid-July. The only thing holding these women back now is the shocking fact that they are still getting paid less than men's soccer players. Hopefully that changes soon. Many long-running American cartoons are finally making some changes to honor the Black Lives Matter movement. The 30-year-old Simpsons show will no longer have white actors voice characters of color. Throughout the years, actor Hank Azaria, who is white, was voicing the American Indian store owner Abu. Now, after following years of criticism, he will no longer be a white male voicing an American Indian male character. In addition, the 20-year-old Fox series Family Guy writer and producer Mike Henry, who is white, is stepping away from his role voicing the popular Black character Cleveland. Within hours of these changes going viral, current casting roles in Big Mouth and South Park also stepped away from the same reasons. American Airlines is throwing out social distancing measures and is instead welcoming back passengers at max capacity beginning July 1st. This means no more space in the middle seat because people will be able to book it. American Airlines will notify passengers if their upcoming flight hits full capacity, and passengers will be able to switch flights free of charge if they don't want to fly on a fully booked plane. Passengers will also be asked during check-in if they have experienced COVID symptoms within the past 14 days. Meanwhile, other airlines like Southwest and Delta are playing it a bit more safe by continuing to keep their capacity around 60 to 67%. Thank you for tapping into the daily news with me. Remember, you can now post your very own videos onto our platform. I invite you to showcase your passions, gain a new audience, dive into a new interest, be current, and start trends. Thanks for tuning into IBBLE Bits, and we'll see you later. Bye-bye.